Hey guys, so today I created this full face glam AF makeup tutorial and I used the Anastasia Soft Glam palette. So many of you wanted to see a more intense look with this palette, so this is what I came up with. And I did do my entire face on camera today, so face, cheeks, lips, all that good stuff. So if you want to see how I got this look, go to keep on watching. Okay, so we're doing a full face of makeup. Full glam, we're gonna do it all. So I'm gonna start with my eyes, then I'm gonna do this eye and eyebrow off camera, and then I will come back and we'll do this eye together. So I will be right back. Okay, so I finally did my other eye. That took a lot of work. I actually did a totally different look on this eye, ended up hating it, so I took it off and started over with something new. So it's been like an hour, and now we're back, so let's do this. I'm gonna start with my eyebrow, and I'm gonna do just kind of like a rough sketch of it. I'm not gonna make it perfect because I will perfect it later. My favorite brow product is the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil, and I use the shade 5 ever since I dyed my hair darker. If I'm my natural color hair, I'm a shade 4. So I just brush my brows up and out of the way, and I start by lining underneath my brow. And I'll kind of brush the product up and through it. I'll do a few little upward strokes up in here, and then I will brush it down, and I will fill in this top area. And then I'll take the Benefit Foolproof Brow Powder, and I use the shade 5, and I take the first shade on the little applicator, and I just kind of push that into my brow hairs. And this just fills them in, and it's super easy to do. And that's kind of all I will do for now, and like I said, I'll fix them up again later. Now I'm gonna prime my eyes. I'm gonna take the ColourPop Concealer in Fair Neutral. And then I use the ColourPop E1 brush just to blend it out. And then I'm just gonna set that with a translucent powder. Now before I start the eyeshadow, I'm gonna take a shadow shield, and I like to cut mine in half like this. I don't like to use the curved edge because it really just gives a weird shape to your eyeshadow. I don't know why they designed them to have a curved edge when I feel like it should be a flat edge, you know what I mean? So I cut them in half to give myself a straight edge. And I follow my lower lash line kinda up to my eyebrow, and that's where I'm gonna put the shadow shield. Alright, now let's do the eyeshadow. On a Sigma E35, I'm gonna take Orange Soda, and we're gonna put that all over the crease as a transition shade. Now on an E25, I'm gonna take a mix of Sienna and Rustic, and I'm gonna start that on the outer corner of my eye and kind of slowly bring it into my crease. And I do bring it all the way out to the shadow shield. I'm gonna go back with my E35 and blend out these edges. On the same E25, I'm gonna take Mulberry, and I'm gonna focus this one more on the outer corner of my eye. Now on an E36, I'm gonna take Cypress Umber, and again we're going on the outer corner. Can you sense a trend here? Now I'm gonna take Noir on an L04, and again, right on the outer corner. This one will go more into like a V shape, kinda like that. And then using my E36 to blend. All right, now we got all this darkness going on, so we're gonna do a half cut crease. I'm gonna take the Urban Decay All Nighter Concealer in Fair Neutral, and I'm taking it on a little flat brush. on an E46, I'm going to take Glistening, and I'm going to put that on top of the concealer. Then I'm going to take Rose Pink, and I'm going to put that right here, so it kind of goes from a glistening to rose pink. And then on the same brush, I'm going to take more Mulberry, and I'm going to put that right here so it will blend the shimmer shades to the darker shades together. I'm going to take off the shadow shield. Ta-da! Now let's move on to the face makeup. Okay, time for the face, finally. I'm going to start with the Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer. For foundation, I'm going to take my current all-time favorite foundation. This is freaking amazing. It is the Maybelline Superstay Foundation, and I use a shade 220 when I have my fake tan on, which is now. This stuff is incredible. It is a very full coverage. It claims to be matte, but it's not super matte where it's completely drying me out. And I do have more drier skin, but I just love this foundation. It wears so beautifully. Do you see that? Holy crap. I really can't get enough of this one right now. And it's drugstore, so it's a super good price. If you haven't tried this, you need to. You need to. I'm going to take Shape Tape in light under my eyes. And I'm going to quickly set that with the Maybelline Fit Me Loose powder. And this is in the shade Fair Light 10. Don't mind my faces. I feel like Maybelline has just been killing it with the face makeup lately. I'm going to highlight the rest of my face with more Shape Tape, of course. And I'm going to set all those areas with the same powder. We're just kicking it on today, but I mean, I said we're doing full glam, so we're doing full glam. Now, I'm going to take the Bare Minerals Bare Pro Powder. This is in the shade Warm Natural 12. This is a trick I learned from Jaclyn Hill. Okay. I'm going to take the Beauty Blender and go bloop, and I'm going to press that into the rest of my face. This just sets your makeup, it adds a little bit more coverage, and I'm also just obsessed with this powder, so I love the way it makes my skin look. Now I'm going to take the Benefit Hoola Bronzer on a Sigma F05, and we're going to contour. Now I'm going to pat over everything with my Beauty Blender. Because we're doing a full face today, I'm gonna bake. I'm gonna take the same Maybelline Fit Me powder. This is actually amazing for baking too. This powder can just do everything. I'm gonna go into the Deck of Scarlet palette that I got this month. Not sponsored, I actually just really like this blush color. And I'm gonna take the Lovesick blush. All right, I'm gonna get rid of this bakage going on. All right, let's highlight real quick. I'm gonna start with the Anastasia Liquid Glow in Oyster. And I take a tiny bit on my Beauty Blender, and I'm just gonna hit the very tip of my cheekbone. And then I'm going to go over that with the Amreezy highlighter. And take a little bit on the tip of my nose here. Now we're going to fix the eyebrows, finish up the eyes, and we're almost done. Yay. All right, let's finish this up. So for my brows, I'm just going to brush through them again. And I'm really going to define this lower line right here. I'm going to take the Benefit Boing Industrial Concealer, and I'm going to take it on a little angle brush, and I'm going to carve out the bottom portion of my brow. I like to do this step towards the end because it cleans up any eyeshadow that might have gotten too high or too close to my brow. And then I'll just take a flat brush and blend out the concealer. Now I'm going to set my brows in place with the Benefit 24 Hour Brow Setter. I like to brush them up because I like that kind of feathery look. Alright, let's finish up the eyeshadow. I'm going to take Burnt Orange on my E35 and just blend that along my lower lash line. And then I'm going to take Sienna on my E25, and I'm going to put that on my lower lash line as well. And I'm blending right into this line that we created right here. Now I'm going to take Cypress Umber on the L04, and I'm going to deepen up the outer portion of the lower lash line, so right here. And again, I'm connecting it to this outer part. I'm going to go ahead and blend with my E25. For eyeliner, I'm going to do a super thin line using the Smashbox Always On Liquid Eyeliner. And I suck at doing this on camera, so give me a second. This eyeliner is super black and very pigmented and very liquidy, so you have to be a little bit careful with it, but I love the way it looks when it's on. I'm going to take the Amreezy highlighter again, and on an E30 pencil brush, I'm going to highlight my eyes. Now I'm going to pop on some mascara and lashes. So for mascara, I use the new Smashbox Superfan Mascara. I tried it out again, and I do like it a lot on my lower lashes. I feel like they look very nice and separated and long. And for my lashes, I used House of Lashes Iconic Light. And here's the final look. So for my lips, I used the Motif Cosmetics Lip Liner in Truffle. This is like my go-to lip liner. And then I popped on the Benefit Lip Gloss, what is this, Punch Pop Lip Gloss, whatever, in Sugar Cookie. And here's the final look, all complete and put together. Yay! I'm really happy with how this look turned out. What do you guys think of it? I love doing a half-cut crease kind of gradient effect on my eyes. I feel like it looks really good on my eye shape, which is a little bit more hooded. So if you have hooded eyes, try this technique. It makes your eyes just look a lot wider, more open, all that good stuff. Skin looks freaking beautiful. I can't get enough of this Maybelline foundation. Literally the best thing in the world right now. I'm obsessed with it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching.